In this video, we are going to check out some of the new additions to Pedalboard in the latest release of Logic Pro. Hey guys, you're here in the studio once again with Luke from guitaristiq.com. Thank you so much for sitting in on this video. As you can see, we are here looking at the new interface for the latest release of Logic Pro. Now, we've already checked out what's new with Amp Designer, and now it's time to turn our attention to the pedal board within Logic. As you can see, kind of like Amp Designer, there are no dramatic changes here to what we're used to in Logic Pro 9, but they have added some new faces to the lineup over here that are definitely going to be worth checking out. So in Logic Pro 10, they have introduced 7 brand new stomp boxes to the pedal board lineup. Let's take a look at these individually, have a look at what they do, and take a quick listen. Okay, the first pedal we're going to have a look at is this graphic equalizer. It's a classic 7-band equalizer. A lot of players will be familiar with this type of guitar pedal. It obviously gives us options for shaping our tone or adding gain or trimming gain before we hit our amplifier. For these examples, we've just got a basic amp setup from Amp Designer. We're not doing anything crazy over here to try and pull tones. It's just about hearing what these pedals are doing. So let's take a listen to the loop we've set up without any effects engaged, just so we can hear everything in bypass. Now let's take a listen to some presets. Next, we have 2 new distortion pedals. Grit, as you can see, is obviously modeled after a classic rat style pedal, whereas Tube Burner gives us a whole lot more options here for shaping our tone. Both of these sound fairly distinct from each other, but they both share the potential in being a little bit overbearing or harsh, depending on how aggressively you're driving them. That may or may not be what you're looking for. Having said that, you can actually wind these back if you're just wanting a little bit more thickness to your tone. So let's take a listen to a few presets. We'll be right back. This next new pedal we have for you is called Flange Factory. As the name suggests, it will give you some of these classic flanger type effects. As you can see, there are a lot of different parameters that will give us options to tweak. In a second, when you hear this, you'll hear some of those classic flanger tones, but what you won't hear is just how extreme this pedal can actually go in the tones that it offers. So if you're using it, all I'd say is use with taste and or caution. Let's check it out. Next up, we have these two pedals for pitch shifting. Basically, both of these will give you options for adding different octaves to the audio you're running through them. Wham over here seems to be a little smoother and more versatile in this respect, adding octaves above the sound source as well as different intervals, but perhaps with Dr. Octave over here, they're going for a less accurate, more vintage type sound perhaps. In any case, there's a lot of fun to be had in pitch shifting. For this example, we've actually put a little melody line over the top of the rhythm track we're listening to, again just running through Amp Designer. Let's just have a listen to that, just so we have something to compare it to without any effects. So now let's check these pedals out. The last new pedal we have in Pedalboard for Logic Pro 10 is this effect called a tie-dye delay. This pedal is capable of producing some, you know, great retro sounding reverse delay effects. These type of effects can range from fairly subtle textures behind what you're playing to a complete ambient wash of sound. There's a lot of fun to be had in reverse delays, so let's take a listen. Thank you. So that's our look at the latest additions to Pedalboard in Logic Pro 10. As with any multi-effects package like this, there's going to be a bunch of stuff that's going to be interesting and usable for different applications, but there's also bound to be some stuff in here that isn't really going to give you the tones you're looking for. It really depends on the track and the sound you're going for. The great thing about Pedalboard is that it doesn't have to be used in conjunction with Amp Designer. If this isn't your favorite amp sim of choice, you can run this into any amp sim software. And additionally, these are all just effects. Obviously, they're tailored towards guitar players, but if you're looking for something more interesting compared to the usual plugins you're using on drums or bass or vocals or keys or whatever, there's going to be a whole lot of interesting options for processing audio outside of guitar that, you know, are going to give you a bit more versatility in your mix. Something definitely worth checking out. So that's what's new for Pedalboard in the latest release of Logic Pro. Well, that's it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you are interested in more videos like this one, then please head over to our website, guitaristiq.com. While there, we would love you to sign up to our mailing list. You can also check us out on Facebook, like the page, leave any questions or comments for further videos. We'd love to hear from you guys, so leave some comments below. Please subscribe to the channel, and we hope to see you in the next video. Thank you.